Hey guys, welcome to a new episode of Matthew Sports Talk. Before we get into anything, I am almost over this damn cold. Still a little congested, but I'm not coughing a whole lot, so that's good. Just to start out with, my God. If there's one team that's cursed, likes to do nothing, kick their fans in the ball sack, the testicles, Minnesota Twins. I wake up this morning to find out that Carlos Correa's deal with the San Francisco Giants was voided because of a failed physical. And what does he do? He signs a 12-year contract with the New York Mets. I mean, I'm like, God, Twins. Twice! You missed out on Carlos Correa twice! Just, God. Just another kick in the damn ball sack. But anyway, on to better news. Oh, and yeah, I remember we're doing this the whole week. Wait. I didn't have the volume up full, that one. Alright. So, yeah. Talk about the Vikings in a minute. Let's talk about the Wolves. So the Wolves are being pretty impressive right now. Finally starting to get things going, despite the fact Karl-Anthony Towns and Rudy Gobert are both injured and on the bench. Monday night, they beat the Mavericks 116-106. Edwards had almost had a triple-double, 27 points, 13 rebounds, 9 assists. Well done. Rivers had 16 points. Jalen Noel, once again, 18 points off the bench. Chris Finch, how many times do I have to say it? Put Noel in the starting five. Like, seriously? It's not that hard to figure out. He will score 20 every goddamn night if you have him in the starting five. Ugh, it drives me nuts. But, the man of the match. I don't have my chain on. Actually, give me 1 second. Musical interlude. Oh, I can unplug my Christmas tree. Alright, there you go. The man of the match who gets the victory chains. Mr. Naz Reid. Double-double. 27 points, 13 rebounds. I mean, this is a wonderful problem for the Wolves to have. But it is slightly a problem when the guy who is filling in for Rudy Gobert, who you gave up so much to get, is performing like this. Like, I did state in a previous episode that Rudy has competition for his spot. This is serious. He really does. Because Naz Reid, if he can consistently put up 20 points or so, and like so many rebounds a night, he's not a scorer. He might put up 20 points or more once in a blue moon, but he's mainly a defender and he'll get the rebounds. He is not a scorer. Naz Reid is a scorer. Like, this is a little bit of a problem for the Timberwolves. So it'll be interesting to see. And honest to God, this is what I would do. Let Rudy heal. Whatever he has, I think it's an ankle injury. Whatever he has, make sure he is 110%. You know, you have the luxury of having Naz Reid. So you have the luxury of giving Rudy Gobert whatever time he needs. So yeah. It's a wonderful problem to have, but it is a problem, unfortunately. So, and then to sum up the stats of the game, Wolves 47.2% shooting compared to 40.8% for the Mavericks. 10 turnovers for the Wolves compared to 15 for the Mavericks. And then 58 points in the paint for the Wolves compared to 18. The Wolves outscored the Mavericks by 40 points in the paint. Jesus, that's a lot. And to be fair, Luka wasn't having his best night. Well, first of all, Luka and Jason Kidd were both ejected late in the third quarter because of a non-call foul. And to be fair, looking at the replay, yes, it should have been called a foul on, I think it was McDaniels, who fouled Luka. But it wasn't like it was a hard foul. It was pretty mild contact, but still should have been called. And yeah, they double technical on Luka, and then Jason Kidd was furious. He stormed the court, and then of course, he's out there, so it was not a good night for the Mavericks. And guess what? We're doing it again tonight. We have a double-double. Oh, not double. A double-header with the Mavericks. So we play them again tonight. So it'll be interesting to see what happens. So, all right. So that's the Wolves. Now I have the updated. Now that week 15 of the NFL is over with the Packers beating the Rams on Monday Night Football. Big whoop-de-doo. I have the updated power rankings. There's been quite a number of changes. So, just in the top five, the top three stayed the same. Philly, Buffalo, San Francisco. Minnesota moved up to number four, and then Cincinnati moved into number five. And then rounding out the top 10, Kansas City six. I moved them down one spot because of that pitiful excuse for a performance where you guys needed overtime to beat the Houston Texans. So, yeah. Dallas, number seven. They dropped four spots because of their loss to Jacksonville. Chargers entered the top 10. They're number eight, jumping up five spots. So did the Giants. Jumped up two spots from number 11 to number nine after their win against Washington. And Baltimore had to drop from number eight to number 10. And then dropping out of the top 10, Miami, just one spot to number 11. And then Washington from number nine to number 13. Some interesting movements. The Detroit Lions are number 12. When the fuck did I ever think the Lions were ever going to be in the top half of the power rankings this season? The answer to that is I never. This season, honestly, I've said this in the past. There's definitely been some crazy NFL seasons. This one takes the cake. Like, teams that you thought were good are bad. I mean, some of them are dealing with a lot of injuries, but I don't know a team that's had the worst after coming off of a Super Bowl. I mean, yes, they have had a lot of injuries, but the Rams, give me 1 second. So this is my rankings I had preseason. So let's just, well, first of all, let me go through the remaining changes on my current power rankings. So, yeah, Detroit's number 12. They moved up four spots. Jacksonville's in the top half, 15, moving up five. New England dropped four. Green Bay jumped into the top 20. Big whoop-de-doo. Raiders are up four, 25 to 21. Cleveland's up five, 27 to 22. Atlanta dropped from 18 to 23. Tampa Bay dropped two spots, 22 to 24. Other than that, not much other significant. Oh, Indianapolis, after the worst ever, up 33-0 at the half and lost. I dropped them from number 26 to number 30. So they're officially right now one of the bottom three teams in the NFL, according to my power rankings. So, yeah, so let's just compare notes. So, preseason, I have Buffalo number one. You know, obviously they're number two right now, so not that big of a change. Kansas City, Green Bay. mean, Green Bay just... Why did I give them number 3? So, yeah, they're down 15 from that. Rams. Although, once again, I reiterate, Rams had a lot, have had a lot of injuries. Denver definitely didn't have the season I thought they were. Tampa Bay. Minnesota, honestly, is doing better than I thought. Indianapolis, Raiders, Philly. I had them middle of the pack, number 1. Arizona. So, yeah, definitely some surprising. And, you know, teams, surprising teams. Giants, I had them 27 preseason, so now they're number 9. And then the Jets, 29. I mean, they have dropped a little bit because they're on a losing streak to number 19, but still. And Seattle, I had them as number 31. Who would have thought that they would be a playoff contending team or a team contending for a playoff spot? So, yeah. It's just crazy. So, I'm not going to do an update playoff picture update. I would hope some of you guys have been following. So, you know. So, yeah, let's get to my week 16 picks. Sorry, I was trying to remember. So, Thursday night, we got Jacksonville and the Jets. Fascinating game. Jacksonville's on the up. The Jets are on the down. I think that will continue. Jacksonville by 4. Bills, Bears. Bills plus 10. Not even a question. Browns, Saints. I have the Browns by 6. Tennessee, Houston. Tennessee by 6. I mean, I think Tennessee will get back on the winning side, but I think Houston will still make it a game. KC over Seattle by 4. Cincinnati over the Patriots by 6. Detroit over Carolina by 7. Baltimore over Atlanta by 6. San Francisco over Washington by 4. Dallas over Philly by 4. Speaking of which, Jalen Hurts is injured. I think it's a sprained ankle. He could be out multiple games. That could be huge. So, just some fascinating news to follow. Raiders over Pittsburgh by 3. Miami over Green Bay by 6. Denver over the Rams by 4. My upset pick of the week is Arizona over Tampa Bay by 3. And the Chargers over the Colts by 7. Now we come to the Minnesota Vikings. The whiteout game on Christmas Eve. Which, stupidly enough, I don't have any white Viking shirts. I mean, I have some gray ones. That's the closest thing I have to white for Viking stuff. So, whatever. I'm going to be repping my man, Justin Jefferson, anyway. So, I give Minnesota's offense advantage over the Giants' defense. I mean, the Giants' defense is really good at, like, stopping the run and stuff. But their secondary, I feel like, gets a little too handsy and it's too prone to getting pass interferences. I think, I'm not sure if Jefferson's going to have a big game. He might be a big distraction. I could see them using KJ, Hockenson, maybe Thielen gets close to 100 yards. We'll see. And then the run game, I'm not sure. I would say, if I were to give an estimate, I think Cook probably get somewhere around 80 yards rushing and maybe 20 or so receiving. I don't think he's going to have a crazy game. I obviously do not think anyone's going to have as crazy of a game as it happened last week. I mean, supposedly the Colts had a good defense. I think the Giants are better. So, yeah. The Giants' offense, I'm going to actually say, draws even with our defense. I know, shocker, right? Really? All they have is Saquon Barkley. I mean, Daniel Jones, don't get me wrong, has improved, but really, their only weapon on offense is Saquon Barkley, and he's been a little hobbled. I think he might actually be on the injury report, and I think he might be listed as questionable. So, yeah, I can't even name a single wide receiver they have right now. I mean, Sterling Shepard's out. Yeah, I can't name a wide receiver for the Giants active right now, so. Special teams, I'm going to give advantage to the Giants. I know the kicker is better than Greg Joseph, even though Greg Joseph has been better as of late. Still going to give them the advantage. Coaching, it's pretty even, both first-year coaches. Brian Daboll has been an excellent coach for the Giants. I mean, yes, they have tampered off since their 6-1 start, but he is definitely a motivator, just like Kevin O'Connell, so... X Factor, Minnesota, it's here. It's a wideout. That's going to be distracting. So, and yeah, I expect the vibes to be livid. So, with that in mind, my prediction is, drum roll please, Vikings 31, Giants 24. And hopefully we'll be doing this. Come Saturday night. Or Saturday midday. Sorry. Alright, guys. So, yep, that's my sports talk for today. Once again, see, we'll see. It's going to be a long day. It's going to be like an 11-hour day for me today. So, we'll see. I might do a Wolves post-game reaction tonight. If not, I'll do it tomorrow morning. And then outside of that, I am probably going to be doing a Christmas Day special. Christmas Day, we are 4 days away from Christmas, which also means 6 days away from my birthday. And I might also do a birthday special, so we'll see. We will definitely see. So, Wolves post-game reaction against the Mavericks either late tonight or tomorrow morning. Christmas Day special and then birthday special. So yeah, that's the next couple of episodes, guys. Until then, see ya. Happy holidays. Skol Vikings, go Timberwolves, and all that jazz. All right, see ya, guys.